Today I'm introducing our Smooth Feed 2 product update to the S Series platform. It's our first major product update on the John Deere S Series since 2019. It's something we're really excited about, introducing some functionality improvement and performance improvement into the product. So what we have is a new chute system, individual chutes for easy removal and access. We've got a simple bypass door that can be removed and put into bypass mode, taken out to access the mills and taken out to access the sieves. The new chute system allows us to drive the chopper into the fully home position, which reduces the distance from the beater to the chopper and reduces the risk of blockage in tough conditions. And it also improves the angle of the bypass chute in bypass mode. So in frosted crops and in really challenging conditions, we've got significant angle on that bypass door to allow for bypass in tough conditions. We've also got a new side drive system, which enables a better alignment of belts. It is mounted to the original slow speed chopper drive, and that means the tensioner is aligned with the original OEM jack shaft mounts. We also have a serpentine belt system under the Terminator. We've developed technology over the last few years, and some upgrades in belt compositions has enabled us to run a single belt around both Terminator mills, and that enables a more robust drive system with higher power transmission and less belts and one less tensioner. So simplified for reduced maintenance and improved performance. We're also introducing our smart alarm system, which connects to the CAN bus of the harvester and monitors the engine speed of the harvester. That means that we can calculate the actual belt slip and alarm only when there's belt slipping, as opposed to when the speed of the mills drops. About 80% of the alarms that we have for a mill speed drop is from the engine speed drop. So we have a lot of false alarms that we are now getting rid of with this smart alarm system. And from a fit perspective, it's easier to install now because we are standardizing the mounting of the bullnose baffle with existing punch out holes. So every bullnose baffle will be installed in the exact same position on John Deere, which is critical to performance and has been one of the major challenges for consistent installs. The John Deere S-Series journey for us has been since 2016, and we've made a lot of design changes that have enabled new technology to be added and new performance to be added. One of the key things that we were able to do is by having our straw streamliner, we're keeping the straw separate to the chaff completely. In the early days, we used to have to have a really large chute in order to prevent blockages in the chaff side. And the reason that we had those large chutes is because there's a proportion of straw landing in them. And with the straw streamliner, we've enabled our chutes to be collapsed to a smaller size and still be able to process all that chaff material. And that allows the chopper to go all the way home. So we have a smaller, more compact chute now, which has been enabled by the straw streamliner technology. The design philosophy of the seed terminator has stayed consistent with a view to be independent to the chopper. The key reason for that is that it allows us to access the terminator mills. We can remove and replace mill components in 20 minutes, which enables you to wear out all the way to finished and replace them mid-harvest, only using bolts. There's no lifting required. You just got to lift out the screens and drop them in. It enables full access to the chopper and enables full access to the sieve to inspect and replace. So the idea of having it independent to the chopper is key for access. It's also key to reduce the load on the chopper. With this single belt drive, we're still having independent connection with the two mills to the gearbox. So if anything happens to one of those mills, the gearbox is still isolated from that load path, which gives it the shock protection it needs. So that philosophy hasn't changed, it's just now a single belt drive.